Hello visual effects people, I'm AK and this is FluidNinja, and we are going to talk about the creation of vector field data. A Ninja is a fluid simulator and it's particularly good for creating flow maps and vector fields, which could be described as three-dimensional velocity fields. And in Unreal usually we are driving particles and GPU particles with this data. So normally we make textures flow and we are working in the texture space, but with vector fields you could affect particles and the direction and the movement of particles. But you will see that a little bit later on. So let me quit this example level, enter Ninja Tools, and let's see how it works. First, I would like to recommend you the page 6 on the intro or the documentation available in the online marketplace page. There is a step-by-step guide on how to do this. But right now, I'm just trying to demonstrate it. First, we go to FluidNinja to create the raw data. Anything could be the base for vector field creation, but right now I would like to paint something. So I go in to this preset, the soft brush thing. I remove this little instructional text and I'm just drawing a circle. Let me arrange the drift, the flow to a circular shape. A bit stronger, please. And here we go. And let's say, you see in the bottom right corner, output velocity. This is that we are going to capture. We could capture a sequence of velocity images, or we could capture a single image. Let's say I'm going to name it circular. And I have two choices. First, in this module, the FluidNinja module, I could go to the side menu button and press this red button here, FGA export. And this is going to create a single snapshot of this velocity field. Well, why not? I'm just pressing this. Here's this pop-up interactive query, and I'm saving it into the output folder. Or I could generate a flipbook, which I'm doing right now by pressing this red button in the bake menu. Here we go. And we save it as a texture asset. And so we have this data saved as an Unreal asset. Let me quit Ninja and demonstrate what we have. In the content browser, I'm going to the output folder. First, you could notice there is a data table file here. That is the file that we generated on the first place. That is a snapshot of that velocity data that we did instantly from FluidNinja. The good thing about this is that you don't have to make flipbooks or anything. You could create a vector field data snapshot anytime from FluidNinja. In case if you would like to tweak things a little bit, it's advantageous to save a flipbook. Let's see how it looks like. Here we go. It's a 4x4 flipbook. And I'm going to use this as an input to create the velocity data. What we need is to go back to the Ninja Tools and pick the Ninja Fields module. That's what I'm doing right now. Okay, a preset is loaded. Let me empty this preset. I'm saying no and no. So this is empty now. And let me click on this roll-down menu and have a look what we have. Circular. This is the 4x4 velocity flipbook that we have been exporting. Let me feed it with this information that is a 4x4 flipbook. And as you could see, I could already slide through the frames. And let's say I would like to capture the third frame of this flipbook. I like this one particularly. And so from now on, I will jump to the next graphical user interface element. And since I have this frame selected, I could set the sampling, the spatial resolution of the vector field I'm going to create, and just press record. And this is going to record the data as a data table file inside Unreal. So I'm pressing it and I'm just saving this one into the output folder. And we are done. So I'm exiting Ninja once again. We have one more file here. Please notice that the first file that we have generated from the FluidNinja model and the second data table file that we have generated from the Ninja Fields model is kind of similar. It contains the vector field data, the raw vector field data. But the thing is that from Ninja Field, you could do a much more sophisticated setup and you could do multi-layer vector fields and stuff like that. But anyway, I'm going to use this. Please notice that we are going to exit Unreal. Why is that? The thing is that Ninja is a blueprint and editor scripting project, which means it is not using any C++ compiled code. And for this reason, we cannot access the UFactory function. We cannot create a vector field instantly from this data. We have to do it by exporting it from Unreal and importing it back. So right-clicking on it and choosing the export as CSV. And I'm exporting it, let's say, to the drive D, to the Ninja output folder called circular. Okay, so right now I'm tabbing to Windows, I'm tabbing to the Total Commander file manager, and you will see what is going to happen there. And here is this CSV file that we have exported from Unreal. I'm just pressing a quick preview. As you could see, it is a raw data file with the coordinates of the vector field, and we have this little meta information in the front at the beginning part of the file, and we are going to remove this by simply using a text editor and cutting out these first few characters until the quotation mark. All right, it's done. And now I'm just drag and dropping this file back to Unreal. So here we go, our FGA file has been drag and dropped back to Unreal. If I double click on it, you could see that Unreal is already recognizing it as a vector field data file. We have a size X, Epsilon and Z, XYZ resolution. And so let's see how to use this. There is an empty particle system here. As you could see, it's like a normal, simple particle emitter. And we have a local vector field module inserted. So let me just pick the circular mode vector field and provide it as an input. And here we go. If I switch the vector field view on, you could see there is this turbulent thing. It is based on this freehand drawing that we have created before. And here is this flow of particles. And that's it, really. That's the way how we create vector field data, and then we convert that vector field data into an actual vector field asset in Unreal. The conversion part is a bit complicated, but again, since Ninja is a blueprint project, we cannot procedurally generate vector field data files. We have to do this trick of exporting the file as a CSV out of Unreal and dragging back, and then it recognizes it as a vector field. Right on. And shortly, and finally, I would like to explain how to preview this file in Ninja Fields. Say I'm saving this file, and on the Ninja, FluidNinja level, Ninja Tools level, I'm clicking on the Ninja Fields blueprint, and you can see we have two functions here. First, list available vector field objects. Here's the list, and here's the circular mod. And build vector field actors for preview. I'm clicking on the second button, and it's done. So I'm entering the FluidNinja toolkit once again. I'm going to Ninja fields. I'm emptying these fields. And probably, yeah, circular mode is here. And now if I would like to, I could couple it with that original file that we had. Probably, yep, circular velocity. And I set the 4x4 thing. And here we go. Or original velocity data. And the resulting vector field data converted into an actual vector field. And in case if I would like to, I could save this as a preset for later use. And that's it. Well, that's how vector field creation works in the FluidNinja VFX toolkit. Thank you for your patience and see you next time.